Hi, everyone. I'm Adrienne Everhart, your dating and relationship coach. I am a feminine energy expert. Today, I'm going to teach you how to be soft and drive him wild. You can actually make a man pursue you, feel so good around you, so comfortable that he wants to pursue you, chase you, and just make him feel wild inside for you. He really won't know why. He'll just know when he's with you, he feels so good and he can't get enough of you. Whether you're dating or in a relationship, I'm going to talk about several techniques you can use today, including your body, scripting, and even problem solving, argument solving. I've got a lot of tips to share with you, so make sure you stick around. If you haven't subscribed to me yet, please do. Go ahead and hit the subscribe button, hit the bell. You'll be notified when I'm live or I have a new video, and I can't wait to share with you how to drive your guy wild right now today. One of the greatest concepts I can share with you is that you want to be soft on the outside and like a mountain on the inside. The mountain on the inside part is your boundaries. This is where you know yourself. You know what you'll stand for and what you won't. You know when to say yes and when to say no. You know yourself. This is a very valuable key component to knowing your boundaries and being strong and solid on the inside. Because with men, you want to actually be soft on the outside. Being soft will actually drive a man wild for you. He'll really want to chase you and pursue you. And like I said before, he won't really know why. He'll just know that when he's with you, he feels calm. He feels wonderful. He feels a soft essence around you that feels like home, that feels good to him. And he really won't be able to get enough of you. Now, if you're watching this video, there's a very good chance you are a PDW. That stands for a powerful dynamite woman. Most of my clients are powerful dynamite women. We are very much at home in our mental energy. We are go-getters. We have successful careers. We, as the matriarch of the household, we have everything in order and everything going on. And you might have had a really strong father figure or a really strong mother figure. It really doesn't matter. But you identified with one of them more than the other one. So you end up inheriting a lot of masculine energy because it's how you get things done, right? It's how you make things happen in this world. The problem is it doesn't work so great with a man because a man is naturally in his masculine energy, and any sort of ordering, instructing, coaching, helping, encouraging him is just going to drive him away. So I'm going to teach you how to be soft and how to soften a lot of these qualities and not completely lose them or lose yourself, but soften these qualities so he won't be able to get enough of you. So intimidating behaviors can be disguised as a lot of little tiny small things you're doing that you're really not even aware that you're doing. And these intimidating female behaviors can really make a man not have this time and space he needs to actually claim you. You become one of the guys. Now, here's how you do that. On an online dating app, you might be having a snarky, joking, back and forth dialogue, and you really feel like you're outwitting him and he's outwitting you, and it's really fun and you're laughing a lot. You'll have this sort of joking relationship, but what you're doing is you're really becoming one of the guys. So then he has this intimidation around you, where he not only has to maneuver around you being one of the guys, but somehow break through to that softness and that vulnerability where he gets to move in a little closer to you. I once had a guy say to me, "Will you stop talking and be still so I can kiss you?" I was that much in my masculine energy, just trying to be the life of the party and a cheerleader and keep things going. Especially in dating apps, when you're first starting to communicate with a man or the first couple of dates you're having with a man, you might have the spotlight on you and just want to show him what a superstar you are. And what it's really going to do is it's keeping you from being vulnerable. And instead, you're going to have this intimidating vibe around you. And the man will then have to jump through the hoop of you being just one of the guys and then move on to, how do I get around her heart? We want to subtract that intimidating part where you're joking, being quirky, being very smart and witty and oversharing, to a place where you're receiving, where you can just slow down that energy and receive from him. This doesn't mean you can't be funny. This doesn't mean you can't tell a joke. It doesn't mean you're not yourself. but you're not doing or saying these things in order to get some sort of reaction from that man. You're doing or saying them because they're very authentic and they're in the moment. What does this require? It requires a lot of observation of the self. And that's one of the things I teach you in all of my programs. First and foremost is we got to get you under control. Because if we're just letting your brain run the show, it's going to do what it's always done. And this is really about learning how to speak and be in a brand new way that's actually very natural to you. We just got to get you practicing it more. So we are going to learn how to practice more being in our feminine energy, which is receiving, being fully present, having empathy, listening, relating to what that person's going through, also sharing about yourself, but sharing in a way that is very warm with your heart unzipped. So what happens when you stop being intimidating? You're vulnerable. And when you're vulnerable, your heart shows to the man. And this is why he falls in love with you. Another example of when we get hard on the outside and we get very hard and this repels a man is that when you're first around men or a man you might like, you might start to zip up and make yourself a little bit small and say, I don't know if he likes me. I really like him, but I don't know if he likes me. And what's happening is you're getting up in your head. And the moment you go upstairs and you're in your head and you're trying to like figure out, does he like you or will he like you? You lose your vulnerability. You lose your softness. What happens if you have a man in front of you and you're act like you don't know if he might like you or not? You don't know if you might like him or not. And you let that natural shyness come through. So often I hear from my clients and they say, I'm so shy to talk to a man. I'm so shy to even look at him or speak at him. Well, you are going to have to do a couple of things to let a man know you're interested with your body language. But at the same time, you can let your shyness and softness shine through. That is a lot of the reason why men fall for us, is that we have this vulnerable, soft side to us that they want to protect. And it's a number of a bunch of other things. But that's the biggest one that I think a lot of women should focus on, is just be yourself. Be who you really are. You're not being a certain personality type or energy because you are out of control. And this is just what you do. You talk nonstop when you get in front of a guy you like. So that's out of control. But instead, come from a slow, deliberate, and easy place of your energy flowing. So see if when you're around men in a public setting, if you can't practice finding what that feels like in your body and kind of oscillating between the two and find out which one feels more comfortable to you. A few quick tips on how to drop that mental agenda when you are out in public, or even if you're chatting online with a man or you're about to go on a date, is one of the biggest things we can do is get into our body. So this is a really important tip I teach you, where you drop down into the feminine. So upstairs is the masculine energy world. This is where you're thinking and doing and action and planning, you're vetting, you're figuring everyone out, you're figuring out, you know, does he like you? Does he not like you? All these things. Busy, busy, busy activity. Drop down into your body starts with taking a couple of slow, deep breaths. Take 3 slow, deep breaths. And with each breath, you want to drop down into your body. Good. And when you do drop down in between the hips, allow them to widen. Allow them to widen and create space there and space between your bottom. Use that whole area to create space and emptiness, and try to breathe into this part of your body. You can also raise your shoulders up and drop them down, raise your shoulders up and drop them down. And there's nothing like a good wiggle, just to wiggle off all the extra nervousness and jittery and energy you might have. Now, this next one comes up a lot, both in relationships and dating. And that's where we talk about work. Now, if you're on a date with someone, they might ask you, what do you do for a living? And you might begin to speak and speak and speak about your career or your job. We are now in masculine energy because we're thinking, doing, processing, and we're talking about work. Ladies, it's the same thing. When your husband comes home from work or when he texts you, he says, how was your day? And you tell him about what happened at work. This does not connect him to your heart. You're staying in that masculine energy, business-minded world. A lot of relationships also get stuck in maintenance conversation, which is basically, I took the kids to school. Did you get the garage fixed? No, I picked up this part for the dishwasher. You're just talking about things that are going on in your life that are maintenance, that are household maintenance. So I want you to think warm honey and creating a bond instead of sharing my pain story with you. We have really become a culture that shares our pain story as a way to connect. But instead, I want you to focus on sharing this warm honey inside of you, this wonderful bond you can create with your man about what you're feeling in your day and what you have felt. So often girls say to me, well, Adrienne, what if I had a bad day? Shouldn't he be there for me? I used a feeling statement. Shouldn't he instantly respond with what I need? First of all, that's not the purpose of feeling statements. It's not to get an instant response or to get what you want. And if you've had a bad day, one of the most important things you can do is just learn how to seek help and support from other women in your life and lean on your man to create that strong, warm, wonderful bond. It doesn't mean you can't tell him that something went wrong and you feel really down and you need a hug, but identify what it is that you want from him. And is it realistic? Is this something we can really expect our partners to give us? But ladies, when you drop down into your body and you find out what it is you really need or want, whether it's what's happened after a long day of work or a long day of maintenance issues, you're able to better understand what it is you need. Again, this takes practice getting back into that feminine energy and finding out what you really feel. Now, if you're on a date with a man and he wants to know a lot about your job, I encourage you sum up your job, your career in one or two sentences and speak about what it does for you from a place of passion, just how your career fulfills you in a passionate way. So for example, I'm an accountant and I work at a very large bank. Think about what you're really doing as an accountant at this bank. Are you helping small companies grow? Are you helping families get loans? Are you helping kids go to college? What are you really helping happen with your accounting position? And speak from a place of passion. Now, if he goes on and on and on about his job, it's okay to act bored. It's okay to get bored. Feminine energy isn't about lying or being untruthful in any way, far from it. You're totally allowed to get bored with a guy, whatever he's speaking about, if he's going on and on about his job, and here's a few quick ways you can show it. These are just a few of my faces that I show when I'm in boredom. And if the man says, oh, are you bored with me? You go, well, yeah, I'm a little bored talking about work. It'd feel really good if we just talk about us though. And he might say, well, I don't have anything to talk about but work. Oh, okay. Is that who you want to be with? A guy who only has things to talk about that are work. That's what dates are for. You're finding out what your partner is made of, what he's about, and how he reacts and responds. And if that's the first date, remember, no one's in their A game on their first date. It usually takes a couple of dates to kind of start to get to know someone. Now, another way to drive a guy wild and make him really crazy for you is that he knows when it comes to arguments, you're not going to have this back and forth engagement of drama that I talk about in the drama triangle. Now, my greatest technique for dealing with this is actually going silent. And you might really have a point to prove. You might really feel wronged and angry. And if that is the case, I want you to wait until you are totally calmed down and in a very neutral energy place before you address this with him. So that bickering, that back and forth, we sometimes get lassoed into it. This is called engaging. If you're familiar with any of my programs, you know I speak often of the drama triangle where you're either a victim, you're a persecutor, or you're rescuing, or someone's persecuting you and you're the victim. And either way, you buy into it somehow. So when you learn how to communicate, especially through a very difficult argument, and you don't fall into persecuting your partner or being such a victim while they're persecuting you. You really learn a new way of speaking and being that's very much grounded in feminine energy. My number one technique for this, and I've saved this for last, it's so simple, it's so easy. Go silent. Go silent. Let your partner say what they need to say. You have a million and one things you want to say back to them, but just nod, take your three deep breaths, drop into your body, and give yourself time to calm down before you continue this conversation. And you can even tell your partner, I need a few minutes before I can talk about this more. I feel really upset. I need a little more time, okay? And you step away and you give yourself time. Now, so often when you are establishing a new behavior, your partner will go, no, 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 you come back here and speak with me now about it. They'll want you to change back to whatever you've been doing before. And this is where you have to be really firm, but soft in your boundary, in your delivery, and just let them know, I appreciate you want to solve it right now. It feels really good that you want to take care of this. I need a little time to think, feel my way through, or think my way through if there's some things you need to think about and figure out. My favorite script with men of all time has to be the following. I want to fix this. What do you think we should do? Not only are you putting the energy back into the man's hands, but you're opening up dialogue for resolution. Instead of like, I'm done, I quit, I can't do this anymore, this is too hard, I want to fix this, what do you think we should do? A lot of times a man will say, I don't know, what do you think we should do? Now this is very important, ladies. I want you to look off into the distance and act like you're thinking, and maybe you really are, and I want you to count to 40. I'm willing to guarantee you 9 times out of 10, within that 40-second count, the man will begin giving you options to fix whatever's going wrong. Trust me on this one. Silence, move slowly, let it unfold. These are some of my best feminine energy tips, and I know they're going to work so well for you, whether you're dating or you're in a relationship or marriage. Now, if you're ready to go deeper, remember, I have online courses. I have my best-selling ebook, which is 500 Ways to Talk to a Man. It comes with a 2-day video class, or I have my FemTools. I have FemTools for dating and FemTools for marriage and relationships. I have so many wonderful programs that you can study right at the comfort of your computer or phone and learn these messages so you don't have to duct tape them together, and you will feel so relaxed in your feminine energy and soft on the outside and like a mountain on the inside. All right, everyone, be sure to subscribe if you haven't already and give this video a thumbs up. I appreciate all your support. Thank you so much for tuning into my channel. I love to hear from you in the comment sections, and check out a few of my other videos too. I look forward to hearing from you soon. Much love. Bye-bye.